Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh amma ba'du fa'uzu billahi minash shaitanir rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Malik Yawmiddin. Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'een. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqeem. Sirat al-lazina an'amta alayhim. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين اللہ تعالیٰ کے فضل کے ساتھ آج ہمیں ایک اور عید الاضحیٰ منانے کی توفیق حاصل ہو رہی ہے. یہ عید حضرت ابراہیم علیہ السلام، آپ کی بیوی حضرت ہاجرہ علیہ السلام اور آپ کے بیٹے حضرت اسماعیل علیہ السلام کی ایک عظیم قربانی کی یاد اور اس کی اتباع میں منائی جاتی ہے. اس قربانی کا ذکر ہمیں قرآن کریم میں ملتا ہے کہ حضرت ابراہیم علیہ السلام نے خواب میں دیکھا کہ وہ اپنے بیٹے حضرت اسماعیل علیہ السلام کو ذبح کر رہے ہیں، اور جب آپ نے اپنی خواب کا ذکر اپنے بیٹے کے سامنے فرمایا تو حضرت اسماعیل علیہ السلام نے جواباً فرمایا کہ اے میرے باپ، تو وہی کر جس کا حکم تجھے اللہ تعالیٰ کی طرف سے دیا گیا ہے، یقیناً اگر اللہ نے چاہا تو تو مجھے صبر کرنے والوں میں سے پائے گا. اور پھر اس کے بعد اس خاندان نے اللہ تعالیٰ کی راہ میں ایسی قربانی پیش کی جسے ہمیشہ کے لیے خدا تعالیٰ نے آئندہ نسلوں کے لیے محفوظ کر لیا ہے. اللہ تعالیٰ سے اپنی خواب کی تفہیم حاصل کر کے خدا تعالیٰ کے گھر کے قیام کے واسطے اپنی بیوی اور کم عمر بیٹے کو بیابان صحرا میں چھوڑ دیا. حضرت ہاجرہ کا دل بھی تقوی اور اللہ تعالیٰ پر توکل سے پر تھا، جنہوں نے فرمایا کہ چونکہ آپ اللہ تعالیٰ کے حکم سے ہمیں اس بیابان میں چھوڑے جا رہے ہیں، اس لیے اللہ تعالیٰ ہمیں ہرگز ضائع نہیں کرے گا. اور تاریخ اس بات کی گواہ ہے کہ اللہ تعالیٰ نے اس عظیم قربانی کو ضائع نہیں ہونے دیا، بلکہ نہ صرف خانہ کعبہ کو اس قربانی سے آباد کیا بلکہ اسی نسل میں سے وہ عظیم الشان نبی مبعوث فرمایا جو کہ پوری دنیا کے ہادی اور خاتم النبیین کہلائے. پس اللہ تعالیٰ کی راہ میں تقوی اور ایمان سے کی گئی کوئی قربانی بھی ضائع نہیں جاتی، بلکہ اللہ تعالیٰ اس کا اجر ضرور ہمیں دیتا ہے. اسی لیے قربانی کے جانوروں کے متعلق اللہ تعالیٰ نے قرآن کریم میں فرمایا ہے کہ ان کے گوشت ہرگز اللہ تک نہ پہنچیں گے اور ان کے خون بھی نہ پہنچیں گے، لیکن تمہارا تقوی اس تک پہنچے گا. یعنی اللہ تعالیٰ اس حقیقی نیکی اور قربانی کی روح کی جزا تمہیں دے گا جس سے تم یہ قربانیاں اللہ تعالیٰ کی راہ میں پیش کرتے ہو. قرآن کریم نے جو اس خاندان کی قربانی بیان کی ہے، اس میں ایک نہایت ضروری سبق بچوں کی تربیت ہے. یعنی کہ جب حضرت ابراہیم علیہ السلام نے اپنی خواب کے متعلق حضرت اسماعیل علیہ السلام کو بتایا تو انہوں نے جواب یہ دیا کہ اے میرے باپ، جو خدا نے تجھے حکم دیا ہے تو اس کو پورا کر، یقیناً اگر اللہ نے چاہا تو تو مجھے صبر کرنے والوں میں سے پائے گا. ہمارے احمدی والدین کو اس ضمن میں یاد رکھنے کی ضرورت ہے کہ جماعت اور جماعتی کارکنان یقیناً آپ کی مدد کے لیے موجود ہیں، لیکن آپ کے بچوں کی روحانی تعلیم اور اس کی ذمہ داری آپ کے کندھوں پر ہے اور آپ اس کے ذمہ دار ہیں. حضرت مسلم موعود رضی اللہ عنہ ایک جگہ فرماتے ہیں کہ عام طور پر انسان اولاد کو خوب کھلاتا پلاتا اور اس کی خاطر کرتا ہے، انہیں یہ فکر ہوتی ہے کہ ان کے بچے خوب کھائیں پئیں، مگر یہ حیوانوں والی زندگی ہوتی ہے، اس طرح وہ گویا اولاد نہیں پالتے بلکہ دمبا پالتے ہیں۔ بہت سے لوگ اپنے اولاد کی بھی اتنی ہی فکر کرتے ہیں کہ اسے اچھا کھلائیں، اچھا پلائیں، اچھی رہائش ہو، اچھا کپڑا پہنائیں۔ بس اگر تم بھی چاہتے ہو کہ اللہ تعالیٰ کے فیوض تم پر اور تمہاری اولاد پر ہمیشہ نازل ہوتے رہیں، تو اپنی اولاد کو دمبے کی طرح نہ پالو بلکہ اس کی روحانی اصلاح کی فکر کرو، خدا تعالیٰ کی محبت اس کے دل میں پیدا کرو۔ جب یہ قائم ہو جائے گا تو خدا تعالیٰ کے فضل بھی نازل ہوں گے۔ ہمیں اللہ تعالیٰ کا شکر ادا کرنا چاہیے کہ اس نے ہمیں حضرت مسیح موعود علیہ السلام کی جماعت میں شامل کیا ہے۔ آج یہی وہ جماعت ہے جو پرانے انبیاء اور سب سے بڑھ کر آن حضرت صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے بتائے ہوئے طریقوں پر اللہ تعالیٰ کی راہ میں قربانیاں پیش کر رہی ہے۔ اللہ تعالیٰ کے دین کی خاطر مال کی قربانی میں تمام احمدی حصہ لیتے ہیں۔ دین کے لیے وقت کی قربانی ہو، عزت کی قربانی ہو، اور سب سے بڑھ کر اللہ تعالیٰ کی خاطر جان کی قربانیاں بھی آج احمدی ہی پیش کر رہے ہیں۔ بس جہاں ہم حضرت ابراہیم علیہ السلام اور آپ کے خاندان کی اس عظیم الشان قربانی کی یاد میں عید مناتے ہیں، وہاں ہمیں اپنا بھی جائزہ لینا چاہیے کہ ہم کس حد تک اللہ تعالیٰ کی خاطر قربانی کر رہے ہیں اور کس حد تک ان قربانیوں کے نمونے کو بڑھایا جا سکتا ہے۔ حضرت مسیح موعود علیہ السلام فرماتے ہیں کہ خدا تعالیٰ نے شریعت اسلام میں بہت سے ضروری احکام کے لیے نمونے قائم کیے ہیں، چنانچہ انسان کو یہ حکم ہے کہ وہ اپنی تمام قوتوں کے ساتھ اور اپنے تمام وجود کے ساتھ خدا تعالیٰ کی راہ میں قربان ہو، اور جیسے تم اپنے ہاتھ سے قربانیاں ذبح کرتے ہو، اسی طرح تم بھی خدا کی راہ میں ذبح ہو جاؤ۔ جب کوئی تقویٰ اس درجے سے کم ہو تو ابھی وہ ناقص ہے۔ اللہ تعالیٰ ہم سب کو اپنی عبادت اور باقی تمام قربانیوں میں اپنے معیار بڑھاتے چلے جانے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے۔ My dear brothers and sisters, by the grace of Allah, we are celebrating Eid al-Adha today to commemorate and remember the great sacrifice of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, his wife Hazrat Hajra alayhi salam, and his son Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam. We find this great sacrifice mentioned in the Holy Quran, that Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam was shown in a dream by Allah, wherein he saw that he was sacrificing his son, Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam. When he mentioned this dream to his son replied that, "O my father, do as you are commanded by Allah. If Allah wills, you will find me among those who are patient." And then the world saw such an exemplary sacrifice offered by this family that God preserved it for all of the coming generations. After having understood the comprehension of his dream, Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam took his family to the desert of Arabia and left them there for the establishment of the house of Allah. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam was a prophet of Allah, but how pious was the heart of his wife, Hazrat Hajra alayhi salam, who proclaimed that, "If you are leaving us here for the sake of Allah, then Allah will never let us go to waste." And the history bears testament to this, that God did not waste their sacrifice. Not only was the Khana Kaaba, or the house of God in Makkah, reestablished through them, but Allah sent the greatest of the prophets, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the progeny of Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam. Indeed, Allah never lets our true sacrifices go to waste, and He always rewards His servants. This is why Allah has said about the animals being sacrificed that their meat does not reach Allah, nor does their blood reach Allah, but it is our pure intentions and our level of taqwa that reaches Allah. Another lesson for us in the story of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam is the obedience of his son, Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam, and the willingness of Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam to obey the commandment of Allah. When Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam narrated his dream to his son, where he saw him sacrificing his son, His son replied that, "O my father, do what you have been commanded by Allah. Inshallah, you will find me among the steadfast in my faith." This shows us, my brothers and sisters, the importance of upbringing of our children according to the Islamic values and instilling in them the love of Allah and the love of their faith. All fathers and all mothers should understand that we are responsible for the upbringing of our children. We should not put this responsibility on other members of the Jama'at. The primary responsibility lies within us as mothers and fathers. And it is our sacrifice and our efforts that will determine the future of our progeny and children and their connection with the Jama'at. Hazrat Muslim Maud Razila Ta'ala Anho says, "Many people worry about giving their children good food, good clothes, and good residence for their upbringing. If you want to receive the mercy of God upon you and your children, then do not nurture your children like a cow," meaning do not only care for only their physical nourishment, but also their spiritual nourishment. Rather worry about his or her spiritual reformation. Create the love of Allah in his or her heart. Make it so that he or she desires the closeness of Allah. When this is established, then you will be the recipients of God's grace. We should be thankful to Allah that he has made us part of a Jama'at of the promised Messiah alayhi salam. Today, it is only this Jama'at which is keeping alive the traditions and sacrifices of the previous prophets, and most importantly, that our master, the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All Ahmadis participate in financial sacrifices for their faith. We sacrifice our time and our honor. Today, members of the Jama'at are being jailed and being killed and persecuted for their faith. So while we celebrate this Eid in remembrance of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family, we should also ponder over our own standards of sacrifice and whether or not we can do more to win the pleasure of Allah. The promised Messiah alayhi salam says, "In the Islamic Sharia or law, God has established various commandments. Man has been commanded that he should sacrifice in the way of God with all his self and his abilities. And just like you sacrifice animals with your own hands, similarly, you should also sacrifice yourself in the way of God. If your faith or taqwa isn't at this level, then it is still imperfect." My brothers and sisters, our religion of Islam, many times when we share or convey the message of Islam, a question that people have is, what does Islam mean? Islam means submission, to sacrifice what we want and put those things aside and do what Allah wants from us. The other meaning of Islam is peace. When we sacrifice what we want and put I, me, and those kind of words aside, and we do what Allah wants from us, you yourself will come under peace. And that is why it says in the Holy Quran, "Allah bi zikr Allahi tatma'innul qulub," that it is in the remembrance of Allah that hearts can find peace. My brothers and sisters, talking about these types of sacrifices, I also wanted to use this opportunity to bring the attention of our Jama'at members to a small sacrifice which I would be asking from all the members of our Jama'at. It is a small sacrifice, but it is a sacrifice in which Allah says that if you do this sacrifice, He promises that He will make us prosperous and successful. If you do this sacrifice, Allah says in the Holy Quran that He knows this is good for you. Even if we think it's not good for us, He's telling us this is good for you. And He promises that He will make us prosperous and successful. And that sacrifice is a small one, I'm asking everybody. Let us try our best to attend every Jummah prayer. Surah Jummah has been revealed in the Holy Quran. And I want to share with you the importance of Jummah and what the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam has said about this. He writes, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam farmate hain ki Jummah Eid hi hai, magar bahut se log is Eid se bekhabar hain. دوسرے عیدوں کو کپڑے بدلتے ہیں لیکن اس عید کی پرواہ نہیں کرتے اور میلے کپڑے کے ساتھ آتے ہیں میرے نزدیک یہ عید یعنی جمعہ دوسری عیدوں سے افضل ہے. The promised Messiah علیہ السلام states, Jummah is Eid, but many people are unaware of this Eid. They change their clothes on other Eids, but they do not give proper importance to this Eid, which is Jummah. And they come with dirty clothes. In my opinion, this Eid is greater than the other Eids. So the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam is making it clear that the way we fill up our mosques, the way we clean and wear new clothes for the Eid celebration today, it is actually more important for us to do this on a weekly basis, and the best time for that is the Jummah prayer. And my brothers and sisters, the reason I am emphasizing this, let me share with you the two verses of the Quran from Surah Jummah. Allah says in chapter 62, verses 10 and 11, O ye who believe, when the call is made for prayer on Friday, hasten, meaning go quickly towards the remembrance of Allah, and leave off all business. This is better for you if you only knew. This is better for you if you only knew. So this is a small sacrifice that we could go to our teachers, our principals, we could go to our supervisors and managers, and at least make the intention that let us try our best to follow this commandment of Allah and ask to be excused for a little bit of time. And Allah wants this to be a test for us. Some people think that, oh, maybe if I take 2 hours of my business time and go to the mosque, I might lose business. Well, that is your test right there. Allah is saying, put your tawakkul, put your trust in Him. He promises that He will take care of us. He promises that He will take care of your businesses. And I could assure mothers who are listening right now, if you approach your children's schools and their principals, and you take out your children from school for 1 or 2 hours for the Jummah prayer, I can assure you that your children will not fail in schools. If Allah Ta'ala is promising that He will make your children prosperous, then we should not be afraid of following His commandments. And then in verse 11 it says, and when the prayer is finished, then disperse in the land and seek of Allah's grace, and remember Allah much that you may prosper. That word keeps coming in the Quran again and again for those people who sacrifice their time, their wealth, and their honor for the sake of Allah. So my brothers and sisters, this is a small sacrifice the Quran is asking us. But in return, Allah is saying that He promises that He will take care of us. He promises that He will look after our children. He promises that your businesses and your work things will go well. But it is up to us to make that intention of sacrifice. My other intention, my brothers and sisters, of asking majority of the members of our Jama'at to make this small sacrifice is that the world is a changing world right now. And even Hazur Anwar has mentioned in many of his sermons and speeches that there is evil attacking us from every direction, whether on your phone, whether on your televisions, whether at schools and colleges or at workplaces. Satan is looking for an opportunity to pounce upon us. And the best way to guard ourselves, the best way to guard our children and our families is inna salata tanha anil fahshai wal munkar. That it is prayers that keeps us away from evil and all types of indecencies. If you want to match and go up against the world right now with all these different things that they're trying to teach our future generations, we will lose this battle. I guarantee we will lose this battle if we do not prepare ourselves. If a boxer goes into a ring without preparation, he will be knocked down. If we go up against this world without any preparation, I guarantee you spiritually we will be knocked down. The Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prophesied, a time will come in this world in which Dajjal will come. And just the other day we had a Sunni brother come here at the mosque, and he started discussing with me about Dajjal. And some of their interpretation is physical, literally, that a person will come with one blind eye and one, you know, eye will be good with the vision. And I explained to him that the promised Messiah alayhi salam, he had a beautiful interpretation of this. He said a time will come in this world, and he talked about Dajjal, the vision that the Dajjal will have will be so modern, technology, science, inventions, all these things the Western, you know, countries in the world will perfect this type of knowledge. But that eye that is blind is the spiritual eye. Faith will leave people's hearts and minds. And we look around the world right now, how many people actually care about God? How many people, just look at your workplaces in school, how many people have a true love towards going to Allah Ta'ala? It is a field that people do not care about mastering. But the promised Messiah alayhi salam has guided us that make this, you know, our perfection. Let us strive towards this way. And Allah says, those who strive in our path, we will guide them towards us. So my brothers and sisters, if we want to attain success, these are all, everything is there for us. It is up to us if we want to make those sacrifices. Nothing good in the world ever comes without hard work and sacrifice. And I'm asking all our brothers and sisters that if you care about your progenies and your future generations and your children to be strong and with their faith and the Jama'at, make this small investment. I'm asking mothers and fathers if you have to approach your principals, their schools, your workplaces, because our progeny, our children, our members of the Jama'at need that time to have that brotherhood. How are we supposed to be good with each other if we don't even get a chance to see each other? How many times I hear some of our brothers say, oh, that Ahmadi, we only see him once or twice every Eid. No, we want to see you every week if it is possible. We have a Jummah center in Abbotsford. There's this mosque here. We have another missionary, Saad Baja Saab, trained from Rabwa Jamia. He's also here at the Surrey Namaz Center. There's a center in Vancouver. So we could come up with 100 excuses if we want to stay away from this. But if we have any intention of success and to be prosperous, the Quran says it right there. Leave off your business and make this small sacrifice and come towards Allah and His remembrance every single Friday. And I assure you, inshallah, if we do this with good intention, I assure you your children will succeed in their studies. Your businesses will be okay. You will not fail in your businesses if you make that small sacrifice. So my brothers and sisters, the other important aspect of this is that we will not succeed if we do not have a brotherhood. If we do not get a chance to meet each other, say salam to each other. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if we want to increase love between each other, say assalamu alaikum to your brother every single time you see them. He said, even if a tree comes between you and you see the brother again, say assalamu alaikum. And this is the way to create a unity and brotherhood. Without this, brothers and sisters, we are just another organization. There's many different beautiful organizations in the world. If you look at the Sikh community, very powerful, very organized. The Mormon community, very powerful, very organized. So my brothers and sisters, if we expect to make a difference in our Jama'at, especially here in the Vancouver area, we must be united. If there's any ill feelings towards any brothers and sisters, life is too short for these things to go on. Forgive your brother and sister. Do we not feel that on the Day of Judgment, Allah Ta'ala forgive us for our weaknesses and our shortcomings? So if somebody wronged you, forgive that brother or sister. Shake hands with him today. If you haven't met him for a long time, shake hands with him today and say, Assalamu alaikum. It's these little things, my brothers and sisters, that will create unity and love. And without that unity and love, there's no way to succeed. So until we come to that level through worship and brotherhood and unity, then inshallah we will see differences. So I'm hopeful that this is not the only time I see some of my brothers and sisters. I'm hopeful that every Friday, inshallah, we get a chance to see each other and renew that friendship and love between each other. And with that, we pray that Allah enable us to follow the footsteps of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and win the pleasure of Allah Ta'ala. Alhamdulillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'uzu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina من يهده الله فلا مزل له ومن يزلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر. My brothers and sisters, we will do silent prayer now. I'd like to ask everybody to please remember all our brothers and sisters in their prayers. those who are sick, those who are going through persecution in different countries, those who have different types of problems and grief. Remember all our brothers and sisters in your prayers. And after the dua, there will be an announcement of nikah. Those of you who can stay, please stay for the dua, to be part of the nikah ceremony. But those of you that have to leave, I'm requesting everybody to please quietly leave and don't make noise inside the mosque. If you have to go outside and talk, you could go outside and talk. Please join me in silent prayer. Ameen. Eid Mubarak. So in a couple of minutes, we'll start the nikah ceremony.
Yeah.